Alright guys, so what we have here is a blindingly bright old school gun. This is an Adrenalin Angel LCD. As you can see, it's done in a very bright anodizing pattern. It's yellow to orange to red fade. I think this might actually be like an illegal anodizing pattern by NXL standards today. You'll have to correct me on that if I'm wrong. But you just don't see many guns this bright anymore. I mean, this is as bright as it gets. Might not be a good gun for like a camo player or someone like that, but you know, if you're trying to be flashy and you know you grew up in the old school 2000s, you're gonna love this gun. But anyway, so this is an Adrenalin Angel LCD, so it comes with all the Adrenalin milling and all the Adrenalin mods. And so as you can see, it's got the cuts on the solenoid housing here, the tapered breech block with the lightning bolt, as well as the Adrenalin skull, well, flaming skull jewel. Then we have the ropey twisty milling out in the front of the feed neck, which is nice. And then we have the, it's Adrenalin's milling on the mini rig. So it came in two different styles, the standard as well as the featherlight. And this one has more of your standard milled look to it. And then in regards to mods, so Adrenalin, you know, did their mods to their private label guns back in the day. We have the high-rise feed neck with the air assist, then telefeed, the blinky LED light on the back, their milled down detent, which I think is kind of cool. I mean, who would have thought to mill a detent, you know? But, you know, that's how the private label guns were back in the day. They were all trying to make a name for themselves. And then we have the Adrenalin volumizer. The Adrenalin snake tongue trigger, which I think is kind of cool. And the Adrenalin breech knob. This one came in stock silver. There was a handful of them that came like this. Not really sure the story on it. I guess I could switch it out for a yellow one that I have, but I'm going to keep it as is for now. And I think that's about it in terms of the mods go. Whoever originally ordered this gun ordered it with, I guess, like a upgraded barrel, and these dye titanium glued boomsticks are like one of my favorite barrels. So this kind of came out before the dye ultralight, and it's definitely a lot lighter than the dye boomstick, the stainless boomstick. But this came out before the ultralight, and you know they had it matched anodized on the front, so as you can see. Definitely a smooth gradient fade to it. So this barrel shoots really great too. I think it's like a 0.688, so it's an overbore, but yeah, I don't know, it shoots great. If you get sand in it, it shoots sparks. Not that I would know, but you know, all those guys in California and whatnot, they've taken videos in the past of them doing that before. One thing I forgot to point out, so it's got a Adrenalin's milled in slide switch on off, kind of a tongue twister. So they replaced the stock on off back here with their more LED style esque on off right there on the side of the gun. So I was trying to think how I acquired this gun. It's probably, I'm gonna say 6 to 7 years ago. But I really don't remember what the acquisition story was, so sorry guys if you're into that sort of thing. But when I got it, I did a couple slight add-ons, put on some slight add-ons, including these pearl grips. I feel like it accents the anodizing, makes it stand out a little bit. Put the red window tint kit in the grips to sort of match the red on the barrel. I added in these buttons, these orange buttons. And I took off the clear hose and put on a yellow one. Just feel like it matches it. Makes it look a little bit more custom. And then I completely rebuilt the gun with all new rubber and new grease and tuned it. And it shoots phenomenal. It's got a brand new battery in it. And yeah, I played with this thing like, I don't know, maybe 2 or 3 times. But definitely a great shooter. Points really nice. It's a little bit more lighter weight because it has that titanium boomstick to it. But yeah, really nice old school classic paintball gun, private label. And that's all she wrote. I'm gonna have some shooting videos and some gameplay videos after this, and so you guys will be able to see it in action. So hope you enjoy and stay tuned for the next one. Thanks. Guns dwell set to 16. Max rate of fire is set to 7 since we're running a Revy. Paint today is Dick's Black Friday Special. So it's like a 0.678. And the titanium boomstick's a 0.688. So we're extremely overboard. We're hovering in around 282 to 285 feet per second. So just where we want to be with small paint. And yeah, so let's let it ride. Too bad. All right, so now I have the rotor on it. Shooting the same paint, real small paint through the 0.688. This is set to full auto at 13 BPS. I've never actually done this, so it'll be an interesting little test. But let's see how she rides. Not too bad. Shoot it dry because I know I'll chop. Anyways, looking good. Thank you.
on me right now.
Hey.